Hey guys, welcome back to Glamorized Beauty by Sasha, and today's video is going to be all about lashes and liner. So I'm going to start with the liner, and we're going to be talking about cake liner, and we're also going to be talking about gel liner. So we'll start with the cake liner, and this is cake liner, and this is how it looks. And what it is, it's a water or sealant activated liner. So this is what it looks like. If you rub it, nothing comes off on your finger. This is what it looks like before you activate it. Now, the way to activate it, you can use a cake liner sealant, which is what I use, and a little dropper, or you can use water. And then you just need a liner brush that's going to be really skinny at the tip that can give you a good application for your liner. So what I do is I'll take this, put one drop of sealant in, because that's really all you need. And what you want to do is you want to wait a couple seconds. You don't want to go right into it and start putting it on. You want to wait a couple seconds because it's a cake liner. You want it to get thick and cakey and creamy. You don't want it to get too thick, because when you go over your eye, you will not get, you know, one stroke even consistency. And then you don't want it to be thin, because it will not be as black. It takes a little practice to get it perfectly, but once you get it, it's relatively easy. What I'm gonna do is just take my brush and just swish it around, and as I'm doing that, it's just basically just thickening it up. And then I just start right on the inner portion and take it right on over. And you want to go very close to your lash line. That's it. Now, you can always step that up a bit. You can make it a little thicker, and you can always wing it out. I always prefer a wing. I just love a wing. So I'm going right back into it. It's still the same. As you can see, it's still cakey. And I'm going to go right back into it, and I'm going to add a wing. So I'm going to start right at the middle, and I'm going to start bringing it up. Now for the wing, I just take it and draw it out. Like that. Then I'll just go in under it to right there. And now here's the wing. Now if you're working with it and you're taking your time, the good thing about it is it dries really quickly. So as you can see, just from working with it, that's basically almost dry. So if you need to add more or you need to touch it up, you can always just go in, add another drop, and continue working. Now to fix this, let's say for instance you were doing it and your brush went up or your hand slipped, you want to immediately take a angled brush or a flat eyeshadow brush and just go in with whatever color you already have on your eye, because you want your shadow to be done before you do your eyeliner, and just take it and go right over where you messed up. And then you could just go in back with a cake liner to fix anything that you may have messed up on. Pros and cons of cake liner. The pros is that for me, it's easy to apply. It dries really fast. It doesn't smudge. And it really is black. It does not crack. The cons is if you have watery eyes, that if it gets wet, it's going to smudge. If it doesn't get wet, it'll be fine. But if it happens to get wet, or you rub your eye and your finger is wet or something, or you rub your eye and the moisture from your eye gets onto your finger, it's going to smear off and it's not going to look good. So now we're going to move on to gel liner. And this is the gel liner I will be using today. It's by Wet n Wild. And this is actually the brush. I purchased this brush separate from the liner. And I'll put a link to the name of the brush and where I purchased it below. And it's just a very small angled brush. Now gel liner, it takes some getting used to, and it takes some practice as well with anything else, because it's not as precise as a liquid liner. You could skip easily with a gel liner if you're not, you know, you don't have a steady hand or you're not good with it. It's always good that if your hand is not steady to rest your arm on something, so that way no matter what you're doing, you have a steadiness. Now, tip also to applying good gel liner is you want to make sure that your brush is clean for each application. Once gel liner dries, it gets extremely hard and your brush is not going to give you the same application. So you always want to make sure that when you, before you do your gel liner, you clean your brush, or after you do your gel liner, it's best to clean your brush because the gel is still soft and it hasn't had time to dry and harden. It's easier to clean. A tip and trick to cleaning your gel liner, which is what I always use, is I have a little oil sample. This is just some Crisco oil sample I got. I just take a pin drop of oil and I'll take it on a napkin or in a cap of something and swirl the brush around in the oil, and that loosens up all of the gel instantly. It cleans it faster and better than makeup removal for me. So let's start with the gel liner. Now, what usually I do is I have little sections in here that I switch my brush back and forth. So I will take my brush in and I'll just like this, and I'll just swipe it back and forth in one section, basically piling the product in the tip of the brush. You don't have to put the product all over the whole brush. You only want to put the product on the tip of the brush. On the tip of the brush, you can pull your eye like this, which works sometimes, or you can just leave your eye as it is. It's always easier when you pull your eye, but some people do not like to pull their eye, so it's completely up to you. Most times when I do it, I do not pull my eye, but by my mirror being so far away, I'm going to actually pull my eye for the application. And with this, I start right on the inner corner. Sure, I got my brush. And I just make little strokes and go over to make sure that it's even. And you can always, when you run out of product, just go back into your product and, you know, like I do, I go back and forth and at one little section, get the product on the tip of the brush. And wing it out. And that's it. Now, another good thing about gel liner is you can also use it to line your lower waterline. So I'm going to do that just to show you that it can be done and how easy it is. I just take my brush, go back into the gel liner, and I just pull down. And I take it right on over. Can make it as thick or as thin as you like. I prefer the thicker, just me personally. And that's it on the gel liner. It stays all day. It has an amazing stay power. It does not crack. If you rub your eye, it doesn't move. It stays exactly where you put it. And a good thing about it is on your waterline, usually you would use eyeliner, then you would set it with a shadow to make, give it that stay powder. With this, you don't have to do that. This is perfect for lining your waterline. If it gets wet, you're fine. It's not going to move. Now, the pros and the cons with gel liner.
The cons is if you're not familiar with using gel liner, or you're not good at gel liner, that it is going to be extremely, you know, a little harder for you to get used to, especially if you're not using the proper brush or if you're not cleaning your brush after each use. That's why at first when I started using gel liner, I was not fond of it. I didn't like it because I didn't realize that I needed to clean my brush after every use, and the stuff would just get caked up on the brush and I would go back to try to use it and it would just be a disaster. It wouldn't give me that smooth, even finish. The pros is I love it. I don't know if I'll ever go back to cake liner, and I love the gel liner, and it's really reasonable, but I still also do love the cake liner. It's like it's 50-50. I love the gel liner because I can use it for two uses. I can use it for my upper line and I can use it for my waterline. I don't have to worry about lining it with the eyeshadow and setting it. It's going to stay all day. Now with the cake liner, you can't line your waterline with the cake liner. It's not a good look when your eyes naturally have moisture and it's just going to be a mess and be a disaster. So I would not recommend using this on your lower waterline, only for your top line. If you have any questions in regards to the liner, feel free to comment below. I will put in the below bar all the products I use, the cake liner brush, the gel liner, and the gel liner brush. So, I hope this helps someone, and thanks for watching. Bye, guys.